What's up, family? Welcome back to the spot. Welcome back to the kitchen. Today we are making my four cheese mac with shrimp. It is so good, you guys. I promise you will not be disappointed. I typically do these when I'm having a little gathering at the house and I want to make things look fancy. Throw them in a little plastic cup and voila. All right, we're going to go ahead and get started. I started with some cleaned, peeled, and deveined shrimp. Left a couple of tails on the end for presentation purposes. I'm going in with some salt, pepper, garlic powder, some Old Bay seasoning, and some paprika. And I'm going to go ahead and give those a good toss. We just want to make sure that everything is good and coated evenly with our seasoning. Here, I'm going to be adding just a drizzle of olive oil. I'm going to give them a good coat so when I throw them in the skillet, they actually sear. We want a nice color on them. We want to lock that taste in. I'm placing my skillet over a medium to high heat because, like I said, I want the shrimp to sear. I want a nice, kind of like a little bit, just a little crisp on the outside. I make sure my skillet is hot before I start adding the olive oil and the butter. I want to say that's probably about a little bit over a tablespoon of olive oil and a tablespoon of butter. I'll make sure to include the ingredients and the measurements in the description below. And while we're getting that butter melted, if you'll see my pot over to the side, that silver pot, it's full of water and salt. I'm going ahead and bringing that to a boil so I can toss my noodles in when I'm ready. And here we're going to go ahead and sear our shrimp. I'm going to sear them for about 1 minute on each side. I don't care to cook them all the way through because this is going back in under some heat. It's going in the oven once we put everything together. So like I said, I'm just getting a nice little sear, getting some color, and locking the flavors in. You can use whatever size shrimp you like. I'm using the 3140 count. And make sure you use raw shrimp. Don't use cooked shrimp. And we're going to remove our shrimp from the skillet. In the same skillet, we're going to make our sauce. Throwing in some butter. Throwing in some minced garlic. And we mix. Or whisk. And I want to do my best to, you know, move that butter around the skillet. I want to get all of those seasonings that stuck to the bottom of the pan. I want to pick those up. That butter will help do it. I've turned my skillet down to medium from medium high just because I don't want to scorch my garlic. Garlic will scorch very easily. Now we've gotten that melted down. I'm adding 2 tablespoons of flour. We are making our roux here, people. Roux. This is our base for our cheese sauce. And I'm going to whisk that around. I'm adding at 1 tablespoon increment at a time. So I've added 1 tablespoon, whisking it around to get a feel, see what it looks like. And then I go in and add more. If you feel that the temp is too high, it's okay to turn the heat down just a tad bit. Make sure you don't leave this roux. You don't want to burn the roux. The roux will burn very easily if you have the skillet too high and if you walk away for too long. And don't mind me flicking stuff everywhere. I was moving quite fast and my little helper had just left, so I had to start doing stuff by myself. All right, we've cooked the roux, cooked that flour taste out. It didn't take long, maybe 2 to 3 minutes. And now I am adding in my liquid. This is milk, and I'm adding it in at about 1/2 cup or 1 cup increments, whatever feels good. What I'm looking for here is a consistency. So I pour, whisk, Once I feel like it's kind of incorporated, I pour some more, whisk. And once you see the consistency, you'll understand what I'm saying. It's all incorporated and it's mixed well. So I'm doing 1.5 cups of milk. And like I said, adding it in increments. This is really therapeutic to watch. Just to see the consistency come together. It just feels good, you know. Just like this shrimp and macaroni and cheese about to taste good. Now I'm doing heavy cream. I'm gonna do 1.5 cups of heavy cream. I use both milk and heavy cream. I have no reason. I don't know why. I just do. You can use all milk. You can use all heavy cream. It's up to you. But I'm using 1.5 cups of milk, 1.5 cups of heavy whipping cream. And if you'll see that consistency looks really good. Everything looks really smooth. We want to make sure we have enough liquid for our noodles and shrimp. So that's why we're using 3 cups. Now you gotta season your sauce. You don't want no bland macaroni and cheese. The shrimp is gonna be seasoned and then the sauce not. And whoever eat that, they're gonna talk about you. All right, we're seasoning it up with some salt, pepper, garlic powder, Old Bay and paprika. The same thing we seasoned our shrimp with is what we're seasoning our sauce with. And like I said, I'll be sure to include the measurements in the bottom. I'm really not a measurer. I kind of taste, feel, smell. I use my senses to gauge how much or to use. But I'm gonna do my best to put measurements, the correct measurements, in the description box below. Give that a quick whisk. Get all those flavors in. And you'll see that it'll start to thicken on its own. We hadn't even added the cheese yet. It'll start to thicken. I've tasted it thus far. And, you know, notice that, okay, I need a little more salt. It can take a little bit more seasoning. So I'm adding a little bit more salt and a little bit more Old Bay. All right, now it's time for our cheese. You can use your choice of cheese or you can use my choice of cheese. Totally up to you. I use 3 different cheeses. I use Parmesan. I use cheddar, mild cheddar. A lot of people use sharp, but I'm not using sharp for this recipe. For regular mac and cheese, I do use sharp. But for this one, I'm using mild cheddar and I'm using Havarti cheese. And I hope I pronounced that correctly. Don't judge me if I didn't, baby. I add my cheese in increments just to see, you know, I don't want it, sometimes I don't want it to be too thick, then I don't want it to be too thin. So to maintain control, I add maybe 1 cup at a time. See what it feels like, add some more or don't. And I'm going in with my cream cheese. I use about 4 ounces of cream cheese. I suggest taking cream cheese out well before you start to even prepare to cook, just so it can soften and it doesn't take a whole lot for it to melt down. If you take it right out of the refrigerator and throw it in the skillet, it's gonna take a while. All right, sauce is done. I'm gonna go ahead and chop my shrimp into smaller bite-sized pieces. I used about 1/2 pound of shrimp for this recipe. It's only me and my boo eating, so that's all we needed. You can adjust that measurement however you see fit. And my noodles, they've been boiled, drained. I did not rinse them. I put them back in the pot. I added about 1/2 cup of sour cream. I'm going in with some salt and pepper, and I'm gonna mix. I'm gonna mix until everything is all coated. this was a struggle holding the camera and mixing at the same time and trying not to let the pot fall off the edge of the counter. I'm delicately mixing here. And we're adding it to our cheese sauce. It's getting so exciting because we're close to being able to tasting it. Going in with our noodles and our shrimp. And I did not add all the noodles at once either, because what I don't want to happen is I don't want to not have enough sauce. Too many noodles and not enough sauce. So I'm adding that in increments as well. Adding in increments just gives you control, and I'm a control freak, so that explains the way that I cook. Looks so good. I think I'm gonna add a few more noodles here. I did cook the whole box, but didn't need them. The noodles that I'm using, I forgot to mention, is corkscrew noodles. You can use your noodles of choice, but I'm using corkscrew. I just feel like the sauce just kind of wraps around that corkscrew shape and it just holds on to it, hugs it. So good. Forgot my little clip where I sprinkled the cheese on top, so don't judge me. I just sprinkled up the remaining cheese I had, put some paprika for color, and I'm throwing in some parsley for color. They call it food grass. And I'm going to throw it in the oven at 350 degrees for about 20 minutes uncovered. And voila, this is what you got. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Even more than that, I hope you enjoyed the food. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button before you leave and like this video. Leave me a comment below and tell me what you think. Thanks, guys. Mm-hmm.